Hi, my name is Dan. In this video, we're going to be using Illustrator to build UI and web graphics. Okay, there's lots of free stuff here on my channel. Please subscribe, hit the little bell next to the subscribe button to get notifications. If you want more, loads more. Okay, check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description. Okay, lovely people. This is what we're going to be building in this tutorial. We're going to finish off the desktop, build the tablet, and mobile versions of our wireframe. I won't be offended if you just skip to the next video because it is literally just kind of doing the same thing but working to a different grid. Do we learn heaps more? We learn how to make a stripy line over here. Okay, so if you want to hang around for stripy line, let's get into it. All right, so we need to finish off our desktop view. So we're just going to add another row of images. So I'm going to select all three of these guys, hold down my Alt key. Drag them down, nice. And we're gonna add in some social icons down the bottom. So my rectangle tool, there he is. He's gonna have our no fill, our kind of off-white fill and a black stroke. And my social icons are gonna kind of reach across, I'm not exactly sure. Okay, but that's gonna be my social icons. Grabbing this copy just so that the font is exactly the same. Like I said, hard to grab when you're at some certain levels. You gotta grab it right in the middle. Okay, and this is gonna be my social icon, social. I can't spell social, wow. Okay, social icons, and put it in the middle. My middle is in there. Okay, copy and paste that, and this is gonna be my copyright. And what I might do just to save some time, get my type and get it to right align. So that it goes copyright, copyright, and copyright 2017. Interesting thing is under type, the copyright symbol is under the something called glyphs. To use it, double click it, okay, and you'll see it appear in there. Close down glyphs, helpful panel that was. And we're gonna put in sample company. Great, back arrow, just kind of like nudge it along so it sits on that column there. Nice, so that's my desktop finish. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom out a little bit and I'm going to grab my artboard tool. I'm going to grab you from the bottom here, drag it up, and I want a bit of a padding at the bottom there. Great. So back to my selection tool, and we're going to start with the tablet version. Okay, and the easiest way I find to get started is just to copy and paste across. Okay, and in my case, I might grab these guys. Okay. You can copy and paste and drag, or I hold Alt often when I'm dragging. Line them up there. Okay, my hero box needs to come in as the first one. Okay, great. And this logo box is probably going to be the exact same size on this side. And my navigation, I know my navigation is reasonably small. Okay, so it'll fit in here. You might have to adjust the size of your logo on tablet. Okay, and it's just a matter of working out what looks good at tablet size, okay, the different layout that you plan to use. So I'm gonna go through. The big change for me is I would like to just do two of these guys. So I'm gonna bring them across. Actually, what I might do is bring one across because they're gonna have to be resized. So I might as well do one of them and then duplicate them. He's lining up with everything. Zoom in a little bit. Command one just to make sure it's perfectly lined up. And I'm just gonna drag him in a bit. Okay, and I'm gonna hold Alt. I'm gonna do two of these guys. Okay, I'm gonna make my artboard bigger. Zoom out a little bit, artboard bigger. I've kind of lost my grids down here. It's a bit annoying, but I'll be able to work it out. So I want them to go 3x3. Okay, you've seen one of the nice things that happens. Can you see there on the right here? I can't let go of my mouse, but on the right hand side there, it says, would you like the gaps to be the same? Some of the cool things you can do with Illustrator. Cool, so next things I want along is my social icons. I'm gonna zoom out again. Yeah, and it's just kind of rebuilding it over here. Now, I can't see my guides, so I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna have to show you how that works, right? So I'm gonna line these up. I could probably just get away with, can you see it actually snaps to the guides at the top there? Okay, but you might have the question of how do I fix this? Okay, so what I need to do is two things. It's easier if I move these bits kind of just over here for a second, then go to view, go to guides, where are you? And go to unlock guides. Now I can select all of these guys, okay? And with the black arrow, it's not as useful as the white arrow. So the white arrow, and I select all of them, I grab these little end anchor points, which you're gonna learn more about later on. You can see I can drag them all down. Now, you wanna drag them down straight. Remember, you can hold shift to drag them straight, okay? Perfect, and I'm gonna go back to locking our guides. So guides. Lock guides, please. Okay, I'm gonna grab this stack back. You guys back into position. Try and get the same gap, nice. Okay, my artboard's gonna have to get a bit smaller. And what I'll probably do is my social icons is gonna get smaller when it gets to tablet. And maybe they'll share the space in here. Might have to change that a little bit when I've got the actual icons in to see them, depending on how much the client has. Okay, so I've only got a few that'll work. So last bit is the tablet, the mobile version. I might just kind of like get in early and get this guy to be a lot taller. Okay, and what I'm gonna do in this case is, this is where probably I've started with desktop and moved to tablet and then to mobile. I find that's the way I work the best. But if you are, it's very common and cool, I feel like, to start mobile first. It's the hardest one to design for, and I agree. But I find like the people that come to my site, okay, is desktop is a huge majority. So I spend more of my time on desktop and I kind of peer it back for mobile. There's loads of people who argue that that's the wrong way of doing it. If you're doing app design, there's no point doing a desktop version. So you'll start with this kind of smaller screen and it is the hardest one to design for. So it's up to you. I'm gonna grab some bits that I need. I'm gonna probably grab all these guys. I'm going to hold Alt, drag them across. Okay, you can do yours one by one. And what I'm gonna definitely have to do is, the navigation's not gonna fit, so we're gonna kind of move it down to, basically it's called a nav sandwich. Okay, so I'm gonna grab my logo, I'm gonna move that across. Okay, and in this top part along the top here, we're gonna draw ourselves a hamburger menu or a nav sandwich. So those three stripy lines. And we're just gonna use three stripy lines. Okay, so I'm gonna draw one, I'm gonna draw two, I'm gonna draw three. Mine have no stroke applied to them. Before you start drawing, you should probably check that you've got black lines selected. I'm gonna do mine separately, they're still there. Okay, I'm gonna grab you guys, your black, and I'm gonna make the stroke better, be it actual view, so you can get a sense of what size they should be. There's no definite size for them, and I'm gonna make sure that they're separated correctly. So up the top here, there's one that says distribute centers, okay? And it just kind of like lines them all up. And that's what I'm gonna do for my nav sandwich. Okay, grids off, grids on. It's about the right size, maybe a bit big, but that's okay. And what's gonna happen here is this is gonna, okay, get down to, where's my grids back? Okay, so my big hero image is gonna be a lot smaller. And the text here, although I didn't change the font size over here because I allowed a bit more room, when it gets to mobile, I'm definitely gonna have to change the font size to something smaller. Okay, and what I might do is actually just make sure I've got, so it ends at this DM. Okay, so I'm gonna make it a bit smaller. Okay, and you'll notice down here, I'm not gonna line up with the grid. Okay, there's a couple of tricks we can do to kind of force that to happen. Okay, and where is it? DM. So I'm gonna delete, watch, put a return in. So that's all gone. And maybe line it up nicely. Okay, the other thing I'm gonna do is select it all and I'm gonna change the format here. So there's things you can do easily, like when it gets from tablet to mobile, I'm gonna make sure it lines up center and that's gonna be okay. It's a nice easy thing to do. Same with this guy, he's gonna be centered in here as a big button. Here is there. Okay, nice. And the font size gets a bit smaller. Next thing I wanna do is make sure this is lined up. Didn't do that. All right, and what I'm gonna do is, instead of, these are just gonna stack on top of each other, so I'm gonna copy and paste one, move it across, okay, and get you to come out to meet the sides there. It's actually gonna be bigger on mobile than it is on any other view. And I can kind of see from this view here, I've gotta make sure that these things are lining up perfectly. You get in there, nice. Back to command one. Okay, and what I'm also gonna do is, instead of having six, I'm gonna cut it down so that actually we only have four of these. Okay, why? mainly because I want to show you what it looks like, how to turn them off when we get to building our website. Okay, so we can turn these off in code. So we only have four of them going, and just so that it's like not so epically long. You can see here I've got four of them already, and the page is also already much longer than the tablet version. So a lot of scrolling. Okay, and what I'm going to do down the bottom here is I'll grab this social icon and I'm going to stack these guys differently. Okay, so I'm going to have them on top of each other because they just couldn't go side by side here. And that's something you can do in code as well, easy enough. Where, make sure you copy them when you're dragging them. Tap it around a little bit. Grab this one. Okay, and they're going to be centered on top of each other. Great, spacing's good. Upward tool. All right, and that is going to be our wireframes. So this might be the biggest, longest, boringest of all the tutorials here in Illustrator. I promise we're going to get into some super fantastic font designing, color using, image mind-blowingness next, I promise. All right, next video. How good was that, right? If you want more, go check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description.